About a year ago, I figured, what the hell? Can I build a 3D game in JavaScript? And spent a few hours pounding out a quickie, TIE Fighter-inspired game. And it didn't look half bad. Well, it's the 1 year anniversary of that crappy attempt, so I'm thinking, sequel. First things first, we'll get a basic scene going that'll serve as our new space game. Which in reality just means a cube map of space, basically. Of course, you need a player, so I've just dumped in this quick box to serve as the main player, and we need to create a player controller and third-person camera classes to follow it around. Those are pretty simple, I've covered them quite a bit in previous tutorials. The third-person camera is basically just a chase camera with an offset, and looks ahead of the target by some defined distance. The player input is similarly simple, checks key input, caches it, and then we interpret it in another controller class that turns the player based on left, right, or whatever you pressed. This looks like nothing right now, we've just got that static space background, but I swear this is actually moving since the box has a velocity. So let's add some other boxes, like evil enemy boxes, and those will be both the enemies in the game eventually, and also serve to kind of give us a sense of distance right now. And we'll spawn a bunch of these guys everywhere. And there we go. You can see that they're in the world, and we're moving in relation to them since they're all static. They're all just kind of doing their thing, so let's kill them now. Peace was never an option. To add shooting, we'll check for the spacebar key and then fire a particle out and forward from the player, killing whoever it hits. The only problem is, how do we detect a hit? 3JS has a ray implementation which we could conceivably use. It's straightforward since there's a ray box intersection test, but if we want to do anything more advanced, we can't. So let's go with a full-on physics engine instead, something like ammo.js. If you go on the 3.js example site, you can find some simple demos showing off ammo.js physics integration. Here's a wrecking ball style one, can like spin it and knock over stuff. Anyway, the point is that I should be able to use the source for these as a jumping off point. I'm building out a simple ammo.js wrapper component that'll do the basic initialization, copy-pasted pretty much directly from the 3.js examples. And then I need to build out some simple rigid body components. This means now I can do array intersection query without much effort. Just cast a ray in the physics world, and if we get hits, we can get back the entities that were hit. Easy peasy. I've covered particle systems before on this channel, so what I've done here is coded up a quick one using additive and alpha blended particles together. I do a quick expand out, and then slow all the particles down, bringing in the smoke. Looks pretty explodey. That means in the game now, we can go pew pew pew, and hit other entities. And I made it so that they die in a little fiery explosion. You can see I added a few other little touches here too. There's a crosshair in the middle because aiming without one is hard, and I added little light flashes where the laser starts. I thought that looked kinda cool. That also means that we can detect when we hit another player and take damage in that case too. So in-game, when we slam into one of the enemies, we'll blow up. Which I feel is fair, because I mean, if you're in a jet and you collide head-on with another jet, odds of survival seem pretty low. Boxes are kind of stupid, so I'm on Sketchfab here looking for some models, and we'll just hot swap them right into the game instead of the boxes. Just need to load the GLTF files. That looks alright, but we can do a bit better. Maybe what we can do is add some nice engine rockets or something cool like that. I'm just going to quickly crap out some particle systems. They'll fire out some additive fire particles, and we'll just offset them manually to match the positions of the engine exhausts. I'll do the same with the blasters, get them to actually fire from the wingtips. Now it looks way cooler. Looks like this thing is actually traveling at some speed, so I'm pretty happy with this so far. In my old demo, I had a Star Destroyer. It did nothing, just sat there looking scary and projecting Imperial power and whatever it does. So let's fix it so that this thing actually does something. Ammo.js has the ability to support arbitrary meshes, instead of just boxes and spheres and other stuff. But there's no handy example to just blatantly steal from. I could break down and use Babylon.js, since they apparently have physics support built right in. But that sounds like even more work, since then I'd have to learn two new things, Babylon and physics, And learning two things is harder than one. What I ended up doing was following the ammo.js docs through to the Bullet Physics original docs, and screwing around building out a triangle soup to feed to the triangle mesh class. Ended up just being this loop here, and we're all set. But before I head much further, I'll take the existing Star Destroyer mesh and build out a simplified one in Blender. Which of course means remembering how Blender works, since I can never get anywhere in Blender without doing a refresher tutorial. How this program works just does not stick with me. Anyway, just need to take the model, simplify it a bit. There's a bunch of modifiers and stuff, and I can also delete everything I don't care about until we end up with something faster to work with. That all works, or it should work, technically. You can see that I'm kind of skimming around the Star Destroyer, and to confirm the collision is actually working, let's do a nosedive right into it. Alright, see? That worked. Watching some footage of the Star Wars Battlefront game, they have cool space battles right in orbit around the planet, so we need to make a planet. But I have no art skills, and no plans of developing any. So this will be done in code, by making a big sphere and applying a shader to it. I'll just throw a bunch of warped fractional Brownian motion at it and mix between colors until we get something decent. Check out Inigo Krila's site for a detailed rundown on domain warping. But it looks cool, it's basically shader magic and noise, and I think it works great for a planet. Once I load that up, we get a pretty decent planet going on here. I keep it at a constant distance away from the player, so you can't actually go and land on it, it's really just a big sham. I can kill everyone, well, not the Star Destroyer, but everyone else, which isn't super fair, so let's make them shoot back. The Star Destroyer has a bunch of turrets mounted all over it, which will make do stuff. In Blender, what I'm doing is removing the turrets and exporting them separately as their own models. We'll make this new turret entity using that model. Now, ideally, I just have some metadata on the Star Destroyer that told me where and what orientation the turrets were at, but I don't know how to export that, so I'm just going to do it manually, placing each of them by hand, and this took quite a while. Then you got to make a quickie crap AI for them. It'll just scan for new targets, and once it acquires a target and locks on, it'll take pot shots at it. The awesome thing now is that if I fly around, they'll take some shots at me. I purposely made them pretty slow turning and adjusting, so you've got to pretty much fly straight at them to get shot, but it works. They'll shoot you. Now let's make the TIE fighters shoot back. The old demo just had them randomly firing, which was admittedly pretty stupid. So in the code here, what I'm doing is adding Boyd-like behaviors to them. They do collision avoidance, wandering, and most importantly, they have an attack behavior that locks on and tries to target you and then take some shots. It works pretty well once you're in game. If you fly around long enough, they'll take some shots at you. And just like in the movies, their aim seems to be pretty crap and it's a miracle if they ever do hit you. I'm going to claim this is by design. I'm pretty sure these ships have force fields or something, so I'm checking out some reference shots for that kind of thing. Star Trek, or whatever, it's all the same. Big blue glowy thing around the ship. I figure I need to create a sphere and scale it on the y-axis to make it more into a saucer shape than anything else. Then, I can take a shader, add some Fresnel type of effects so that only the edges show and the middle goes away. I'll also add a whole bunch of random noise on there. In the shields component, we'll register to get notified on every hit, and using some more noise, maybe you're noticing a pattern here, we'll bounce the visibility in and out a bit using an elastic ease-out function. The end result is that this all looks pretty passable. It's not terrible, it looks like magic sci-fi shields, so I'm declaring victory here and moving on. I also want some UI on the screen showing how much shield you have left, so I'm modeling this on my phone's battery icon with the little bars and stuff. I'm going to create a quad and throw a shader on it. The plan is that I'll use a 2D box SDF or sine distance function to create the bars. I'll multiply the UVs on the x-axis by how many bars I want, and then apply a bunch of noise on top. Noise is a great substitute for actual art direction. Looks alright, pretty battery-ish. I'm sure someone with more skill could do more here. Maybe that's a challenge to someone watching this video. Take the code and make this look less like crap. So one final touch. This is pretty decent for a JavaScript game, but let's kick it up a notch. Bam! The MDN docs here describe the GamePad API to JavaScript. Now this is totally unfinished, but it should work for us. We'll need to make this new player PS4 input component. And the cool thing about a GamePad is that you get a range of values when you press the directional sticks, instead of the key presses, which are just on and off. So we'll track the buttons and the axes and use those instead. And here we go. The ship is flying around with the gamepad controllers. Although I could totally just be lying and steering things with the keyboard. I mean, really, how would you know? So here, we've got some little testers playing the game for real using my PS4 controller. While they're playing, I just want to say, make sure to like and subscribe, and if you enjoyed this, support me on Patreon. Now let's look at the complete game. Enjoy! Thank you.